This equation has no real solutions. And of course, if you would like, please pause the video and try this first before you see my solution. Done? Okay, here we go. Firstly, notice we have a quantity squared equals a number. So we can proceed by taking the square root on both sides. That way, square and square root cancel, and we will have to remember to put down the plus and the minus on the right hand side. Now we are going to get two equations from here. The first one is when we have 2 plus x squared equals negative. Let's do the negative first, because people usually forget about the negative. Negative square root of 1, which is just 1. So we have negative 1. Next one, 2 plus x squared equals positive square root of 1, which is just 1. Now from here, notice we just have x squared. So we can just minus 2 to both sides. And then we look at x squared equals negative 3. And then take the square root on both sides. Plus minus, cancel. Here we go, x equals. Notice we have a negative inside of the square root that turns out to be the imaginary number I. And then square root of 3 is just square root of 3. It's not a nice number, so leave it. And then we still have plus or minus. So we actually have two solutions. The first one, plus I square root of 3. Second one, the negative square root of 3 with the I. Yeah. And then I'll just make a little note. I is the number so that I squared is equal to negative 1. So when you have the square root inside of the negative, then you end up with the I. Now for this, do the same thing. Minus 2, cancel, x squared equals negative 1, and then take the square root on both sides, and you see, you know the answer is I, and negative I already. Cancel this, x equals plus or minus, here it's I, square root of 1 is just 1, multiplied by 1, doesn't matter. So there we have it, we have a total of 4. Complex solutions for this very nice looking equation.